subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 28th of September. One Pakistani terrorist captured, another killed during infiltration bid in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Activist raises concern at UN over atrocities in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Gilgit-Baltistan. And workers in Afghanistan's famous carpet trade fear for future after Taliban take over. And now for all the details. One terrorist belonging to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfit was killed and another surrendered in an anti-terror operation which started on September 18 in Uri sector of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir. Briefing the media on Tuesday in wake of the recent infiltration attempts by Pakistan along the line of control, senior Indian Army officials said that the infiltration attempt was made in the area of Salamabad Nala, the same pocket that witnessed a suicide attack in 2016. Security forces also recovered a massive cache of arms and ammunition from the terrorist. The operation took place after a patrolling party saw a group of six militants crossing the border. A firefight ensued between the militants and the patrolling party, forcing four militants to retreat towards Pakistan's side, while two militants sneaked into India. In 7 days, seven militants had been neutralized and one had been apprehended, and five of these neutralizations have taken place along the line of control, the army said. Meanwhile, a huge cache of arms, ammunition and narcotics was also recovered by India's border security force near border area in Akhnoor area of Jammu district.
Now it shows the desperation of Pakistan when he sees that the peace and stability in Kashmir is something that is not to Pakistan's liking. So there is desperation to send in terrorists to create disturbance and some kind of a sensational strike.
In an attempt to create mass awareness for the adoption of climate-resilient technologies, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday dedicated 35 crop varieties with special traits to the nation. These special traits crop varieties have been developed by the Indian Council of Agricultural Research to address the twin challenges of climate change and malnutrition.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday launched 35 crop varieties with special traits developed by the Indian Council of Agricultural Research ICAR to address the twin challenges of climate change and malnutrition. According to the Prime Minister's office, the crops launched have special traits like climate resilience and higher nutrient content and will lead to awareness about the adoption of climate resilient technologies. These special traits crop varieties also include those that address the anti-nutritional factors found in some crops that adversely affect human and animal health. Speaking on the occasion through video conference, PM said that climate change is a big challenge for agriculture and the entire ecosystem and stressed on the need to step up efforts to fight it.
बीते 6-7 सालों में साइंस और टेक्नोलॉजी को खेती से जुड़ी चुनौतियों के समाधान के लिए प्राथमिकता के आधार पर उपयोग किया जा रहा है। विशेष रूप से बदलते हुए मौसम में नई परिस्थितियों के अनुकूल अधिक पोषण युक्त बीजों इस पर हमारा फोकस बहुत अधिक है।
Experts have been warning about the adverse effects of climate change for years. Last month, a report by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, said that climate change will have economy-wide repercussions in India if not mitigated and could lead to shrinking of the agriculture cover in the country. The IPCC report also said that the impact of climate crisis will pose an acute risk to the agriculture sector.
Moving on, political activist Shaukat Ali Kashmiri has blamed Pakistan of subjugating the voices of journalists and activists and muzzling dissent through force in Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. During his intervention at the ongoing UNHRC session in Geneva, the activist urged the world body to intervene to pressurize Islamabad to stop human rights violations in both the illegally occupied territories.
Political activist Sardar Shaukat Ali Kashmiri on Monday has raised serious concern about deteriorating human rights situation in illegally occupied territories of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. Speaking virtually during his intervention at the 48th session of the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva, he highlighted Pakistani security forces operate with impunity and crack down upon journalists and activists in both the territories for peacefully resisting against Pakistan's illegal occupation. He urged the world body to intervene to put pressure on Islamabad to stop human rights violations and repeal all draconian laws which deny them right to expression.
Journalists are threatened, beaten, tortured, kidnapped and killed despite claim the PM Pakistan, government of Pakistan continue to be most dangerous place for the journalists, media person, civil society, activists and human rights defenders. Madam Chairperson, our freedom of expression and opinion is compromised. There are strict restrictions on freedom of expression.
Political activists from Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan had also held a protest in Geneva and London this past weekend to highlight atrocities by Pakistani state and its security forces and demanded the release of political prisoners who have been detained for past several years.
Pakistan's envoy to Kabul has said that Islamabad has discussed the prospect of Afghanistan joining the China-Pakistan Economy Corridor project with Taliban-led administration, as regional connectivity is a way forward for economic interaction. Reports suggest the Taliban, with a need for economic stimulus and international recognition, also seems more keen.
Pakistan's ambassador to Afghanistan, Mansoor Ahmed Khan, said on Monday that Islamabad has discussed the prospect of Afghanistan joining the multi-billion dollar China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC infrastructure project with Taliban-led administration, as regional connectivity is a way forward for economic interaction. In recent days, representatives from Pakistan, China and Russia have held meetings with Taliban officials. Khan said security and economic development were the two main topics under discussion. Reports suggest the Taliban, with a need for economic stimulus and international recognition, also seems more keen.
Pakistan and Afghanistan have 2,600 kilometer long border, and this important project, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor project, which is a flagship project of Belt and Road Initiative, provides good opportunities, good potential for providing infrastructure and energy connectivity between Afghanistan and Pakistan.
CPEC is a network of roads, railways and energy projects linking China's Xinjiang to Balochistan's Gwadar port. Activists blame it has only brought death and destruction for the indigenous people in Gilgit-Baltistan and Balochistan from where it passes, as Pakistani forces operate with impunity in the region to ensure safe passage to Beijing. Pakistan has not yet formally recognized the Taliban-led administration, but Pakistan has had deep ties with the Taliban and has been accused of supporting the group as it battled the US-backed government in Kabul for 20 years. Charges Islamabad denies.
Although the security situation has improved since the Taliban takeover, local businesses in Afghanistan continue to suffer due to economic uncertainty. Women entrepreneurs have also shut down their businesses, fearing reprisals.
Carpets are one of Afghanistan's most well-known exports, having been exported around the world for centuries. Afghans working in the country's renowned carpet trade say they fear for their future and that business has taken a hit following the Taliban takeover. Manager of a carpet factory, Sadat Weaving Company, said his primary market used to be the European countries and the US, with carpets making their way overseas through Pakistan. But now, he said the customer base has evaporated, while prices for materials such as wool are rising.
حکومت قبلی حدود 40-50 نفر کارگمان داشتیم که اینجا کار میکردن در قسمت های مختلف رنگ آمیزی در قسمت پروسس خود مواد اولیه ازی در قسمت بافت ازی مثلا در قسمت ارائه خدمات بر بافندگان و در قسمت طرح دیزاین ازی در قسمت بلتی ازی کارمند داشتیم ولی فعلا خوب ما کار نداریم دیگر کارا سقوط کرده بافت نیست تولید نیست
With the change of government, disruption in banking services and closure of borders, especially the closing of air corridors, carpet industry has been plunged into difficulties. Meanwhile, for 23-year-old Nilab Durrani, who opened the Women's Driving Institution, the first of its kind in Afghanistan, is staring at an uncertain future. She had planned to expand her business by the end of this year. But her plans were dashed with the unexpected arrival of the Taliban in August.
خب ما میخواستم به خاطر شروع کار خود اجازه بگیرم چون ما اینجا کار میکنم و کار من امی است ما از این طریق یک دکمنان پیدا میکنم که امور بخورم او میخواستم کار ما شروع کنم چون وقت کار نکنم طبعا ما پول به دست آورده نمیتارم نمیتونم از این از زندگی خود پرداخت کنم
Durrani says that the day after the Taliban took over, some of their militants came to her office and removed the iron signboard outside. She also claims she was asked to close the office. With her office closed temporarily, Durrani says there is still hope that international organizations will come to the rescue and persuade the Taliban to let women like her continue their jobs and businesses.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Scores of people have been queuing to buy bus tickets in Nepal's capital Kathmandu as authorities have opened advance booking ahead of annual religious festival of Dashain next month. Transport operators, however, said that due to the prevailing COVID-19 situation, the number of tickets being booked has come down as compared to the previous years.
Scores of people were seen waiting in queues in front of the bus ticket counters in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on Monday as the Department of Transport Management and Transport Entrepreneurs have opened advance booking ahead of the upcoming religious festival of Dashain. The Transport Department has decided to open advance booking of tickets while adhering to COVID-19 health protocols to facilitate students and people involved in various professionals in Kathmandu who would be travelling to their home districts. To provide necessary information to the travellers, various help desk and ticket counters have been set up across the valley.
अहिले अग्रिम टिकटको लागि आजबाट बुकिङ खुला गरेको छ नि त त्यसको लागि टिकट काट्न आएको पिठानको लागि
Transport entrepreneurs said that due to the prevailing COVID-19 situation, the number of tickets being booked has lessened down as compared to the previous years. The annual Hindu festival of Dashain is a time for family reunions and prayers, and it is celebrated with great fervor across Nepal. The fortnightly festival will fall on October 7 this year. As of Tuesday, COVID-19 active case load in the Himalayan nation stood at 18,848 with 11,103 deaths so far.
Scores of Hindu devotees in northern India performed rituals and prayers for the well-being of the souls of their ancestors on Monday as part of the ongoing Pitru Paksh or Fortnight of Ancestors. Hindus believe the cycle of rebirth can cease if these sacred rituals are performed during the 16 lunar day period.
Scores of Hindu devotees gathered in India's northern holy city of Varanasi on Monday and performed rituals and prayers for the well-being of the souls of their ancestors as part of the ongoing 16 lunar day period of Pitru Paksh or Fortnight of Ancestors. Special food items were offered by family members in the name of their ancestors as they took part in the traditional Tripindi Shraddh ritual to free their souls. It is believed that when humans die, their mortal body turns to dust, whereas the soul remains until it does not find another mortal body to reside. The cycle of rebirth can cease and the soul can get salvation if these sacred rituals are performed, devout Hindus contend.
16 दिन का जो है तिथि होता है इसमें जो है पितर लोग इस समय धरती पे आते हैं निवास करते हैं तो इस समय पितर पक्ष में जो भी श्राद्ध तर्पण त्रिपिंडी श्राद्ध का विशेष महत्व है इसमें
Pitrupaksha is considered to be a mourning period by Hindus and an inauspicious time to start new ventures or buy anything new.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.